In this lecture, we will cover the concept of solid angle and see it is very useful in physics in solving various problems, especially the flux related problem. So let us first of all see what exactly is the solid angle. We know the normal angle. If we take a two-dimensional object, this is a small object, and we are looking at it from certain point at a distance L, and this is arc, and this is that small angle d theta. We write d theta is arc upon this length from where we are seeing in case of two-dimensional objects. Now, in case of three-dimensional objects, your angle is basically a solid angle. It's a three-dimensional angle. Suppose I look at this book. I look at this book and I am very close to the book. So my solid angle C is much more. If I am farther from the book, if I go away from the book, my solid angle, the span of that angle gets reduced. Like if I look at the sun from here, my span of the angle is very small, but when I go near to the sun, my whole angle span will increase in three-dimensional. Like it case, it happens in the two-dimensional objects. So solid angle, if you take this, suppose this is a patch of a sphere, it's a bulging out kind of it's a patch which has been cut out from a big sphere, and this is the side view, this is the three-dimensional view. It's like a cone with a bulging base. Cone with a bulging base, and that bulging base is basically nothing but part of a sphere which has a radius which is equal to the length of the cone. Sorry, the side length of the cone. If you take this as the radius of the sphere, if you fit this cone in a sphere which has radius equal to this, then the base has that bulging part. You remove the base of the cone, you had a cone, and this was the solid base of the cone. And suppose I make it completely empty. I remove all material from here till here. So it is a hollow kind of a open kind of a thing here. But it's a three-dimensional object. And I fit it in a sphere which has the radius equal to the length of the cone. So I have used this cone and I have fit it in a sphere which has radius which is equal to the length, side length of the cone. So this cone will have a bulging base. And if I divide this whole area, if I divide this whole area by this radius square, this total area by the radius square, I get this angle, which is the solid angle here. Solid angle, the basic thing is, like here, we used a very small arc, keeping in mind that this small length is perpendicular to all the lines which are coming from this point. Similarly, this is the area which is having the surface perpendicular. The surface of the area is always perpendicular to these radius vectors which are coming from this point, or alternatively, the area vector is parallel to these lines. Please note, area vector is perpendicular to the area. If this is the area, then the area vector is this, which is perpendicular to the area. Never take this as the area vector. This anyway cannot be. Does it have any defined direction? If you take this plane, it doesn't have any defined direction. You can take it in any direction. How will you define the area vector? This perpendicular to it, for this particular position, has a defined direction. So it's a vector quantity. So perpendicular to the area, perpendicular to the plane of area, is the area vector. And that area vector should be parallel to all these lines which are coming. Then in that case, this area divided by this distance is the solid angle. So solid angle is d omega is dA upon r square. So if you take a very small patch, three-dimensional patch, and this is how we show, this is three-dimensional patch, and this is that slash cut I have done in the three-dimensional patch. But if you look at it, it's like a bulging cone with area dA, and this is d omega, and this is r, then d omega is dA upon r square is the solid angle. Now let us see the utility. Suppose I want to use this concept for finding out the flux through the base of a disk. Through the disk, there is a disk. I am seeing it three-dimensionally. When I see anything any circular object three-dimensionally, I'll see it in an oval shape, and there is some point here and some charge there. So this will send electric field which will fall at different points in the disk all through. This is a three-dimensional view, and this is the charge. So you see that the electric field which is coming, and if the disk is this, if this is the base of the disk, the electric field is coming, is striking. If you see the side view, the electric field is striking at various angles at all the points. So you can keep on moving in different radius of the circle, and different angles are being formed. Now, how do we find flux in such cases? Because if you take the side view, then you are for a particular radius, at a particular radius, you have this electric field and the area vector making different angles. So you will have to do that calculation in terms of integral and all. You can find out the flux. Flux is E dot dA, and dA here is, please be careful, the area vector means what is perpendicular. This is the area vector. This is a dot product of electric field and area vector. Now, this is you will have to do that calculation, but the easier method is to use the solid angle concept. The solid angle concept is that when any such situation is given, if there is a point from a circular object at some distance, then you do one thing. You take that circular object as a base of a cone and make an imaginary cone. This is a very short method, though the derivation will be long, but you don't have to remember derivation every time. You remember the outcome of it. So this was the disk which I was seeing, and this is the cone which I have made, three-dimensional cone. Now, what I do, and this is the radius of the disk which was, say, A. What I do is I place this cone in a sphere which has the radius equal to the length, this inclined length of the cone. When I see cone from the side, I see the length. So this end to the distance where I was placed. I was placed where I was placed. I make this as the apex of cone, and this distance becomes the radius, and I place it in a sphere of this radius. So I make an imaginary sphere and place this cone in that sphere, and this cone will now have, I say, this cone now turns into a shape, an extra space I am getting. If I take the side view, the cone was like this, but now the side view of cone, I add this part, this part which is because of the sphere, and I forget this, forget the disk for the moment. So this is what I am getting. If I place the disk, even then the angle, solid angle is same. If I remove the disk, even then my solid angle is same. But it is easy to find solid angle when you get this spherical shape, because of the advantage that each plane is perpendicular to the radius, or the radius vector at each point is parallel to that radius. So if the whole angle of the cone is twice theta, please note, whole angle of the cone is twice theta, half angle is theta. So this half angle is theta. This side also theta. I take an angle alpha and a small angle again d alpha. So at alpha, I take d alpha. So what will be the radius of this segment when I look from here? Where this alpha is striking, the radius will be, this will be r sine alpha. So even, let me draw the diagram of this. Suppose this is point A, this is point B. When I see it from this side, I see a circle, and let this be point A, and this be point B. And this was the center. Some angle was made, and it, this angle lands here. Say this point is X. So this angle made a circular kind of thing at point X here. And then I took a small angle d alpha. So this is a, I get a patch on the surface of this sphere. And if I look it three-dimensionally, you are having this kind of a patch on the surface of this sphere. Now this patch makes its own angle, solid angle. You run through the patch on the periphery of the patch and you make a small solid angle, which is d omega. Now d omega, and this is all through this d omega is same. You run all through the segment of the, just imagine a patch on the sphere of the surface of the sphere. And from inside you run through the two peripheries of the patch. This is inner periphery, this is outer periphery. The angle subtended by these two inner and outer periphery is d omega. So d omega is dA upon r square. And what is this area? This area will be r sine alpha into, what is this small width? This is r d alpha, because this is d alpha. So r sine alpha into r d alpha into 2 pi. 2 pi r sine alpha is the parameter. 2 pi r sine alpha is this, the parameter of this circle, which I am seeing as an oval shape because of 3 dimension. And r d theta is the width. So the area of this ring made on the surface of the sphere is 2 pi r sine alpha r d alpha is the area, divide by r square, you get the solid angle. You integrate it. Now be careful, when you integrate in such things, from where to where you will integrate? Will you integrate from minus alpha to plus alpha? Or you will integrate from minus theta to plus theta, because theta is one side and theta is the other side. Will we integrate from minus theta to plus theta? Will it be minus theta to plus theta, or will it be 0 to theta? Please be careful. It will be 0 to theta, because 0 to theta is, this half angle made is taking care of the full circle. Even if I have taken half angle, but the circle which makes here, the which I am considering, is already full. So this half movement will cover the full surface. So do not commit this mistake here. So it is 0 to theta. So finally I get 2 pi r square upon r square minus cos alpha 0 to theta. So I get minus 2 pi, and inside I'll get cos theta minus 1. So I get 2 pi 1 minus cos theta. So remember this formula. This is the shortcut. Don't do the entire derivation in the exam. This is just to make you understand the concept. This is the solid angle of any disk which makes 2 theta angle. If the ends make an angle 2 theta, if I look at the disk from this side, and this is the axis of the disk, and this is the angle made is 2 theta. Or if you take it as a cone, it is the angle of the apex is 2 theta, then the solid angle is 2 pi times 1 minus cos theta. Now see, if you had I gone alpha from 0 to pi, because if I go 0 to pi, I am covering the whole thing. I will not go minus pi to pi, 0 to pi. So at pi, it becomes, if you put pi, it becomes 4 pi, which is the solid angle subtended by any sphere at the center or any whole object. So if you take a sphere, what is the solid angle? Area is 4 pi r square, and inside, I am looking from inside, all the distances are anyway perpendicular, so I can take 4 pi r square upon r square. So the solid angle is 4 pi, which will come as 4 pi here in case it's a whole sphere, but I don't need that. What I need is solid angle made by small object which is not covering the full sphere, but something is given of that. Now, using this concept, suppose I have to find out what is the flux passing through this disk. I am given only this angle being made. Please note, this is 2 theta, then this is theta. If this angle is given as theta, if this angle made by the disk is given as theta, then don't forget to put 2 pi 1 minus cos theta by 2. That care should be taken, keep it in your mind. This is the solid angle. So what is the ratio of the solid angle made by this to the sphere is 2 pi upon 4 pi to 1 minus cos theta by 2. So it is 1 upon 2, 1 minus cos theta by 2 is the ratio of the solid angle of the disk having an angle theta, then it is theta by 2, or having an angle 2 theta, then it is theta. 1 minus cos of that angle divided by 2, whole thing divided by 2, gives you ratio of the solid angle made by that disk to the entire sphere. So if you calculate the flux through the sphere, just multiply this with that, because this is the ratio of the solid angle of the disk to the solid angle of the sphere. So in such problems, find out the flux through the sphere and multiply by this factor. The factor is 1 upon 2, 1 minus cos theta. Theta is half of 2 theta. All right, to remember it carefully, 2 theta upon 2, so that you don't make the mistake of half and full angle. Multiply by this ratio, this factor, and multiply it with the total flux passing through the sphere. So I hope it is helpful.